Hello guys, welcome to my next video, that is input output. We start from a new file. Click on the arrow to make the screen enlarge. Now write hash include, that is our basic header file, hash include void main CLR SCR for clear the screen, get ch. Okay, so in this program first I am going to use only the output statement, that is printf. So printf hello my program. Okay, so first we see the output of this program, that is hello my program. Now I'm going to define a variable here, that is int a equals to 10. Okay, and now using printf I'm going to print the value of variable a. So value of variable a is %d, comma a, pass the variable name. And to print this line, in next line I am using slash n, so alter f9 control f9. So this is the output of the program, where a variable having a value 10, and I'll have print that value using the printf command. Now if I want to take a value from output screen, so what I have to do, I'm declaring a variable here int b. Now I'm printing a statement printf, that is slash n enter a value for variable b. Okay, and using scanf I will store that value into variable b. Okay, and after inserting that value in variable b, I will print that value in next line. Okay, so now we have to see the output of the program. See, hello my program, value of variable a is 10. Now enter a value for variable b. Suppose I am entering 20, so value of variable b is 20. Okay, so this is a small program for understand the input output variable. Similarly, if I want to take character value c float value, so I had defined two variables here, that is character c and float d. So for that I am copying these sentences, statements actually, and paste that statement here. Okay, enter a value for variable c, enter a character value for c. So for character you have to use %c, and for float %t f. percent f t t percent p. So I'm also using this command to make program understable output statement output statement with variable. Okay, easy for you. It is output statement with variable come here now after this line. That is okay. So output statement with variable now input and output statement for integer variable or character variable. Okay, and for float variable. Okay, so in a single program we use all the processes. First we compile our program, give you success message. Now B 20 enter a character value for variable C. Value of variable C is so here is some mistake in our program, that is it is not taking a value for character. So just change the sequence of statements. That is first we take character, then we take integer. Okay, maybe some problem is there. So a value of variable c is a 10. And enter value of variable D is okay. So here is our program perfectly running. Enter character value for variable C. I inserted like slash. Okay, so slash enter a value for variable B. Okay, that is 3. We enter a value for variable D. That is 23.567. 23.56. Okay. Thank you for watching this video. So in next video, we will see about the conditional statement. Okay? Thank you.